Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. I am glad to see you here again with me. For those who don't know me, I am Srishti Arora and I am doing this series kind of thing that is all about scrapbooking, the tools, the comparison between them, which one you should go for, and various tips and techniques that you can try if you are stuck somewhere. And I will be covering everything in detail in the upcoming videos, and I've covered a lot of things in my previous videos as well. So if you are new, just go ahead and check the previous videos. And yes, do not forget to subscribe to the channel so you are updated with all our videos and stuff. You can also follow us on our social media. I will be posting down all the links in the description box below, so you can go ahead and check those too. So this episode or this chapter is going to be about circle cutters. We face a lot of problem if we have to go ahead and cut a circle in the center. Either we can use dies that but obviously you need to have a die cutting machine for that. And if you do not want to invest into a die cutting machine for starters, you can always go ahead and buy a circle cutter. There also comes circle punches. You can go ahead and buy them. But again, you have to buy a separate punch for every size, and you do not get big size circle punches. So suppose if you want to cut a big size of circle into a 12 by 12 inch cardstock, you do not get a punch for that, or you do not get a die for that even. So what you can do is you can go ahead and purchase a circle cutter. So this was the compass cutter which I bought first. It is of Monson brand. It is a compass cutter, so you can just change the radius and cut a circle accordingly. This one I bought from Amazon. I will be sharing the link in the description box below. So if you want to purchase this, you can go ahead and buy and try it on your own. So it came in a packaging, and this is how the caps come off. Here is a compass kind of thing right here, and here is the blade. So this moves like this, and you can adjust the radius how you want, and you can also increase it. Guys, look at this, you can cut a big circle out of it. And again, every dimension is written all over here, so you can go ahead and set your dimensions as per the requirements. I will be sharing how I cut using this. There is also this little cap sort of thing that can be used. I will show you where to use this. Let me keep it aside and grab a piece of pattern paper. So here I have this pattern paper right with me, and suppose I want to cut a circle out of it, say 7 inches radius. So I will just mark the tip to 7 inches. I will secure it down so that it doesn't move. I will secure this one also down so that everything stays in place. And then what I'll do is I'll just put my compass needle it is all similar to how you make a circle out of a compass. So you put your needle right over here and you move your paper and you get a cut like this. Again, one thing that I feel is that if I'm working on a silicon mat, it gives me a better output as compared to a glass mat. I'm working with this first time on a glass mat, so I'm having some difficulties, but silicon mat work perfect. So now, as it was a compass cutter, here was a needle. I have a hole in the center. I hope you can see this. I have a hole right in the center, and if you want this circle to pay somewhere, this hole will not look nice at all. You need a solution for this. Here comes the cap. So all you have to do is just put this cap on the needle, and the needle won't pass through your paper now. And now similarly, you mark the center and just make a circle, just how we do with a regular compass. So again, we get a nice circle cut right out of it. But as you can see, I have these edges, I have these irregular circle edges and stuff like that in this one. So I thought to invest into a nicer one, but I was not sure which one I should go for because there are a lot of circle cutters available in the market. There are not many in India, but a lot of them are available with various brands. Like VR Memory Keepers have a circle trim. They just launched their circle trim, and there is this Martha Stewart circle cutter, and I just wanted to invest into the best tool. But again, as I was confused, then I saw a video and I saw this one. I'll just keep this thing aside. And I saw this circle cutter. Again, it is the same brand. So this came in this packaging. I'll just take it out. So here are the things written. It is a V-structure kind of tool. Then it has a QQ blade. It has anti-slip bed, so it won't slide while you're working on it. Then it has pair blades as well, and it has easy to read measurements. So this is the Monson circle cutter, and I found this really amazing. It just gave me very clean cut and very easy to use, and I'm just in love with this. I'll show you how this one works. Let me keep this aside. So this is my cutter. I have my packing paper right over here. Suppose I want to cut a circle right in the center, and let me just trim it down to 6 by 6 inches. Just trim it down to 6.6 inches. And I want a circle just in the center. So the first step that I'll do is I'll mark the center. So here's my ruler. I'll just go ahead and mark a center point. Right here. So we have a center right over here. In this board, if you can see, there is this marking which indicates the center. So you just have to align it with your center on the cardstock or on the pattern paper. You just have to align it down. Now I need to suppose I want to cut a circle at 7 centimeter radius. So what I'll do is I'll just unscrew it. I'll take my blade to 7 centimeters. And I will secure it down. I will rotate it and secure it tightly. Make sure it is at 7 centimeters. The markings are matching properly. Now, when you secure this using the middle part, there is this top part. And what it does is when you rotate it, the blade comes out. If you can see, the blade comes and goes out like this. Okay, so you take the blade out. Whatever, I suggest if you're working on a glass mat, you take the complete blade out. But if you're working on a silicon mat, it depends on the thickness of your paper then. Now, I will arrange the center to the center I marked like this. And I need to get up for this because it's really hard to work like while sitting down. So I've arranged my center, I've arranged my radius, and now what I'll do is I'll just rotate it. I'll just go ahead and rotate it. And when I take it up, I have my circle right over here, and it is a perfect circle. There are no uneven edges. There is no edge fraying, and you get a proper circle cut out of it. Now again, if you want a bigger circle, for say on the same cut, on the same pattern paper, you're not happy with the center, this one, so you just go ahead and change the radius. Say make it 11 centimeters. Tighten it down. Again, align the center and you cut it down again. make sure you apply some pressure so that the blade passes through your pattern paper. And now you have the previous circle, you have the new circle, and you have a circle right in the center of your pattern paper. So you can use it if and add a photo. You don't have to worry about the alignment. You can use this piece also if for embellishment, and you can even use this one also. So you can play around with it however you want. You can also arrange it like this, you can layer it up and down using dimensional tape. It's all up to you now. So this was that. You can also cut using this cutter on acetate. I have a piece of acetate. I'm just going to put my blade down, my cutter down. Make sure the blade is all out. I'm just putting randomly over here. I'm not going to align a center or something, and I will just rotate it. Make sure you go out and go twice on it, and you apply a nice pressure, because if you are using a thick acetate, the blade might not pass through. So here you get a perfect nice circle, acetate circle. And you can experiment on different things. You cannot obviously cut chipboard through it, but you can cut heavyweight cardstock and stuff like that. So this way you can make cool shaker windows for your cards, and you can just add foam tape right over here, and you can make shakers, beautiful shakers out of it. You can make windows and whatnot. The uses are absolutely endless. So this one I bought like 3 to 4 months back, and I'm very, very, very happy with the outcome. I am actually sad why I didn't bought it before. I will just share the link in the description box below from where I bought it. I don't remember the site. I need to check my mails. So this way it is very easy to cut circles out of this. I feel working on this comfortable as compared to this one, and this gives me very nice and crisp cuts. So again, the maximum size you can go for is 16 centimeters of radius, and you can cut a circle that big on your cardstock. In this one you can go for like 30 centimeters. Yes, you can go for 30 centimeters, but again it is a tedious job to cut a big circle using this compass cutter, and if it ruins your edges, the whole you have to just go ahead and change the complete paper. So I just love this one. Again, same brand, so you can go ahead and buy any if you like. Price, obviously there is some price difference, so you can go ahead and purchase any one of your budget. And as I told you, I saw this Via Memory Keeper circle trim board, and I'm so in love with that. I just want to get my hands on it and work with it, but currently it is unavailable in India. So what I'll be doing is I'll just place a pre-order with someone, or I'll just wait. But the first thing is that I'm going to buy it whenever it comes to India. So it has these, and I bet that it will be very easy as to work with as compared to this one also. And you can do a lot of things using that, as it is a Via Memory Keeper's tool. And again, in a Via Memory Keeper's tool, you can always make the most out of one tool. You can make multiple kind of things using one tool itself. So I just want to try my hands on it. Again, there is this Martha Stewart trimmer. You won't get any issues like piercing through the paper or stuff like that. It is available in India with some sellers, and I will go ahead and browse the options and link it all in the description box below, so you can go ahead and check that too. But for now, this is the perfect option for me. Perfect option to cut circles, whether it is cardstock, whether it is a heavyweight cardstock or pattern paper, acetate, vellum, whatever it is. You can cut perfect circles out of it, and you can make your projects, beautiful projects out of it. So I'll be soon doing a project using this circle cutter, and I will be posting the tutorial on YouTube itself. So make sure you are following us and stay updated with all our videos. and this was all about circle cutters. And if you have any questions or if you want to ask something about any brand, just drop down a comment and I will try my best to help you out with it. And if you enjoyed the video, just hit like, share it with your friends. That will mean a lot to me. And again, I will see you soon with another video. Till then, have a great time. Take care and bye.